And welcome back to Ring of Man Legacy Collection Part 6. And last time we actually learned that that Dr. Wily is not so smart of a mad scientist as he just has recited his old scheme. Well, alright, he did it a bit better in that he wore a disguise when he tried to recycle it, but still, Megan has already 5 times defeated him, so why in hell would he still keep bothering? But then again, I guess mad scientists do have that habit of not knowing when to quit. So let's just keep going to this actually quite offensive color scheme having level. Or however you wanna call it. Ah, damn it. And now they actually did add some gimmicks and platforming challenge to this. But nothing which cannot be made through. Interestingly, when you get damaged, you just get knocked down by those things. And trying to be. Ooh! Shit, how in hell you could know that's there? Yes, in these later Mega Man games, they actually went into those cheap shots about difficulty. Like that was in that. There's just very little of. Very little time to see that there's that platform over there. Yeah, you can use the jet, but they actually managed to bring thing like momentum, meaning you don't stop right away when you are maneuvering this jet, which is in a sense realistic, but for platforming, it's a real pain. There you are. Oh, but of course that might be that what I sometimes spoke earlier about that. Like that. Very little time to react. And quite difficult maneuvers as you simply don't know what there is beneath you. And practically it's also quite difficult to actually figure out how fast you should go. But yes, and here you have to do a bit of a tricky. Yes, it's they do really do have amped the platforming difficulties in this phase. Let's just get going and hope that I can now make it. This is nothing. It's the next part with spike mazes, which is the tough one. Down. Down here. Destroy the fucking thing. Jumpy puzzle. Go down here. And do this. Oh, but I did not notice this place. Of course, because this is actually quite bitchy part of spiky mazes. Well, let's just keep going down here. Oh yes, there's an E-tank. Let's go and take it. And hopefully there's a bit less asshole-like spike corridor, but it's clear that Dr. Wily himself has actually learned about his mistakes. Oh shit, don't tell me this is a spike pit. No, it wasn't. In that he's putting a lot of these instant death spikes as he knows that titanium tungsten carbide super robot with human-level intelligence and cognition actually as weak as in that his huge armor chassis cannot take any kind of hit from pointy metal objects which are in spherical form. Weird. God, robot pests. But looks like we are now in a full weapon energy, which is good, knowing that there's a lot of damage. Yes, they do not anytime so-called fuck around about in level of difficulty. They're pulling everything, difficult spike drops. The spike drops monsters in hard places, shooting shit where at you if you can, which is very difficult to dodge or avoid. But that's just... But let's just scrap that monstrosity and go forward carrying. Someone might have noticed that I don't use much of these Robot Master weapons in this game builds, because most of them are pretty redundant. They do have the specialist services, but they don't feel as fun as the earlier Mega Man weapons. Oh shit, oh look at that, Dr. Wily has built himself a giant battle robot. Which is fire at me. But looks like he doesn't like being speared. But then again, yeah, usually dragons are killed with swords or arrows. But this one is apparently killed with a lance. But then again, why you wouldn't be able to kill a dragon with a lance? And yes, stabbed it to the head. No, not to the soft underbelly. To the head. I wonder just where does the Dr. Wily get money to build all these mad scientist fortresses, which this time had actually a bit of a Japanese flavor in its appearance. Oh, there's a new tank. No need to... And they're actually ice physics now. Although mom say that in Mega Man games the ice physics usually have not been so overwhelmingly tough or... They are usually quite nasty, but sometimes it seems they're also in the levels which don't feel like they should have slippery physics. Like Flashman's level, because nothing in that level indicates it should be slippery, but it is. And now, a bit of a tricky maneuver, as these have come back. Hell yes, I didn't actually... There probably wasn't any in this game earlier, but now Dr. Wily has is bringing them back as well. But no, I'm going this way. I don't like those blocks, especially when there's spike bits beneath them. And of course, knowing that they are quite annoying, those blocks, they all have shown up in every Mega Man game. And once again, we go back to the ice field. Fly over and grab some weapon energy and fly down. Oh yeah, those things are actually quite funny, yeah. When you shoot them, they start to get angry as they lose their sunglasses. And they are actually pretty dangerous when they are not wearing their sunglasses. And a bit of a tricky maneuvers. High spikes and pits and doing some jet. Maybe jet wasn't so necessary, but this color scheme in here is quite obnoxious. And he's built some sort of a... Oh, looks like that monster thing is weak to spear. It's good. And it's more to ram us. That isn't so much of a difficulty, it's just the fact that it's attacking so much makes it a bit of a tough... Oh, spears did it damage, but Windstorm made it even more damage. But Dr. Wily hasn't actually brought any real big surprises about his defenses, this spikes, spike pits, disappearing blocks, and a couple of ugly monstrosity robots. But nothing else. But oh, even if his current crib looks a bit of a Japanese padoga. Well, it's a water level, and we're gonna continue here next time. And interestingly, that water bubble screen from Mega Man doesn't actually go any further than the surface of the water, which is a real nice sense of details they Capcom, voice of Capcom managed to do to this, their swan song about, although technically this hasn't proven to be a swan song about awesomeness, but this was the last classical Mega Man game and it's working real good. They're pushing the hardware really far, and I'll see you next time.